Hey, hey, everybody. Welcome, welcome. We are trying something new today, and we're hoping that it's a long line of amazing podcasts coming your way. We are so excited to launch to you the Connected Growth Coaching Podcast. Yeah, we see this as a big picture vision. And so we wanted to hop on and do the first episode by just telling you, like, what's the podcast going to be about? Who's it for? What can you expect? What kind of value are you going to get? And who are you going to want to share this with so that all the people in your lives are living and breathing the amazing tools that we share in Connected Growth Coaching? The number one thing that this podcast is about is rediscovering who you are. It's the everything of what we do.
Right. It's the foundation. It's the foundation of everything moving forward in your life and reconnecting with that.
So, Jen, tell me what rediscovering means to you. What does it mean to you?
What does it mean to me? It means connecting back to my core self and getting back into who I am authentically and then feeling empowered and energized by that and moving forward in my life. And so every time I feel spun out, I feel stuck, or I feel confused, I just reconnect back in because I have all these amazing tools from Connected Growth Coaching that have propelled my life forward in a really amazing way.
Yeah, for me, another piece of it is just sort of peeling back the layers. Like many people who are listening have lived 30 plus, you know, some of our, whatever. You've lived a lot of lives, so a lot of years. A lot of lives. That might actually be true too.
In many different ways, right?
We'll save that spiritual woo for later. But you lived a lot of years. And so for me, like, a lot of the rediscovering is like peeling away layers of stuff that have piled on over the years, like stories from other people, like messages from the culture about who we're supposed to be. And so the rediscovering for me is like, wait a second, what happens when I strip away everyone else's rules and stories
expectations
and I just figure out who I am again? And so we've gotten really good at it. we've gotten really good at it ourselves and then been able to share it with clients. And now by stepping into this world of podcasting and blogging and just being able to reach more people beyond our client base, it's really exciting. So that is definitely the core, rediscovering who you are so you can thrive. Because when you're disconnected from who you are, you're kind of in survival mode. It's like everything's about, like, how am I going to get through the next minute? How am I going to get through the next thing? How am I going to get through the next workday?
Hamster wheel. Constantly, right?
Yeah.
On that spinning wheel of going nowhere.
Yeah.
No growth, no happiness, no joy. You know, it's an awful place to be.
Yeah.
And a lot of our clients come to us going, please get me off of the hamster wheel.
Get me out. So that's it. Rediscover who you are so you can thrive. And we're going to share with you the tools that we use, the tools that we use for ourselves, the tools that we use with our clients. And those are feng shui, life coaching, talking about inspired action. Like, how do we take inspired action, not just hamster wheel action? How do we live purposefully? How do we live our purpose? How do we make a difference in the world?
How are we making an impact in the world?
On
the people around us, a positive impact on the people around us and out in the world, and just feeling good about that. Feeling energized and empowered in your life in a whole new way, like waking up in the morning and just being excited and ready to go. about everything.
Or not being excited and being like, okay, I don't feel excited. How am I going to get excited?
Get excited.
Oh, yes. Bam. Mm-hmm. I might not have felt it when I waked up. When I woke up, but I want to feel it. I know that I want to feel it, and now I know how. Right. Because I have the tools.
Right.
Because Jen and Amanda give me the tools.
Yeah.
As if we are the only tools. No, and that's the thing. Like, we're just one more tool for your toolbox, right? Yeah. You probably are already, you probably have a good handful of tools in your toolbox, and we are just adding. We're adding another weekly listen for you, another weekly read, some exercises and practices that can go into your toolbox.
Right. Or you've tried all the things and haven't gotten the results that you've wanted, right? I think that's the number one thing that we're hearing back is that people have tried all the things. They've been in this, you know, personal growth world. They've been in this personal development world, and they haven't achieved the results that they've, or they haven't been able to sustain the results that they've wanted to. And this connected growth coaching model has propelled them towards that in a completely different way. And so that's what we're really excited about, is hearing that kind of feedback, that it's something new and different, using ancient wisdom, right? The contemporary twist that we put on it and making it relevant in your life right now.
Yeah. Awesome. So that's what the podcast is going to be about. If you stuck with us this long but don't know who we are, Jen is coming from a really strong feng shui, interior design, like sort of shape your external spaces, right?
Shaping your external space to reflect how you want to feel on the inside. Yeah.
Right.
Yep.
And I am Amanda Kingsley, coming at you from a more internal place. Like, what are the thoughts happening in your mind? What is the, how do you reach the goals that you want to reach? What is the inner voice, the dialogue in your head, and how do you change it to get the results that you want? So,
and you are a magician with that.
And
you are amazing. We were just doing it this morning because we practice what we preach.
We do.
And she was able to flip something around for me that made it just, it's a game changer, game changer.
And it's great because this morning, Jen and I were talking about how we've known each other for a long time, but we're just starting this work together.
Mm-hmm.
Can you hear my dog? Sorry about that. So we're just really forming this partnership together. And Jen is she's a ninja, we call her. She's just a wizard with the feng shui. So the external spaces and helping those change the way you feel, like, that's just so easy for her. And she comes in and she swooshes it all around. And then it takes a little more effort for her to dig into her mind. And that's what I help her with.
Right.
And then it's the complete opposite for me. I look at my space and I'm like, what do I do? I don't know what to do. I know if I do something, I'll feel better, but I don't know what it is. And then if I dig into my mind, figure out what's happening in there, then I look back up at my space and I'm like, oh, that's what I need to do. And so that's the magic of us working together, is that some of you will really latch on to the inside out perspective, and some of you will latch on to the outside in perspective, but what you need is both. And that's right. What we are together.
Into the yang.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's pretty much magic.
Yeah.
So who's this for? So this is for women who's this for, Jen?
This is for, it's for women who are looking to to connect back to something they've lost, right? That they've lost touch with. I think a lot of times we, as moms, we really lose our creative side. We lose touch with who we are and what makes us truly happy. We could tell you, you know, 1,000 times over what makes our kids happy, or what makes our spouse happy, you know, are their favorite foods and all that kind of stuff. But we have completely lost touch with that core feeling for ourselves. And so it's regaining access to that again.
Yeah. And that something you've lost piece doesn't just go for moms. Like, let's say you jumped out of college, went right into a corporate career. Mm. Well, it's your boss who you know, right? Like, you know what the corporate world wants of you. You know what your boss wants of you. You know how to make that next promotion. But do you know what you really want? Like, have you lost touch with what you really want? And so there's so many places women in particular get lost in the world. Mm. Mothering is huge. I feel like corporate careers are huge. The whole relationship dynamic and the cultural experience of the feminine and the masculine. So basically, like, wherever you've been lost, like, mm-hmm. that's where we want to bring you back from.
Right. Yeah.
And then we're, our target audience, the people who are really going to resonate with our message, are people who want forward momentum. They're like, all right, well, that was pretty awesome. How do I step it up a notch?
Right.
How do I grow even more? Like, people who want to keep going.
Keep going. Keep going. The entrepreneurs, right?
Yeah.
People that are looking to take their business to the next level or to even start a business because they're not fulfilled within their corporate career, that they've always had a passion for something and now they are looking to fulfill that monetarily, you know, I think we get a lot of entrepreneurs. In our last Connected Growth 1.0, we had all of the women had some kind of entrepreneurial spirit, whether they had already in their own businesses and wanting to take it to the next level, or have an idea about a business and wanting to take it to, you know, take it and create a business around it, or just, I'm thinking of one person that came up with an idea decided to start a business, you know.
And maybe it's not a business, maybe it's a nonprofit or a project or like community service something, but like, yeah, we definitely are people of momentum and growth, so we tend to attract people of momentum and growth.
Yep, absolutely. The people that want more, that feel in their hearts that they were meant for more.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And those very same people are the ones who want to show up and do the work. So I know myself, like, I've listened to a lot of things, read a lot of things, gotten excited about a lot of things, but it's not until I sit down and do the work, mm-hmm. right? That I sit down and journal, or I actually apply the feng shui, like, that's when it happens.
Right.
Over and over again. Yeah. It's taking action. Right. So everyone is welcome to listen to this podcast, but the community of listeners who apply what we say and then come back next week for the next layer of it, they're the ones who are really going to build momentum and create sustainable change. So we're excited for you. If you are one of those people, if you know those people, like, this is the place to be. All right. Yeah. So, and that's who it's for. Yeah. Anyone who wants to make a difference in their own lives, in the world, in the big picture, in their small community, in their family, in their marriage. Like, if you want to show up and make a difference and grow, like, welcome.
Yeah.
Welcome. So let's talk about what you can expect. Like, what's the podcast going to look like?
You can expect us to show up shiny and bright. We are very energetic people. And
so true.
Yeah. And we just like to share what we have to offer. And we like to do that. We practice what we preach so that we can show up here fully and transparently and guide you through this work from a place that's, you know, really from a place that we've already experienced, right? And so it's, yeah, that's...
And it's a lifestyle. Like, for both of us, this is a lifestyle. If I go, let's be honest, if I go 24 to 48 hours without checking in with my mind, like, I'm toast. It's over. Like, it's just like eating healthier, exercising. So we maintain the lifestyle for ourselves so that we can show you what's possible and we can help you learn how to maintain it for yourself. If I, like, I just recently dug back into some of the feng shui. Like, we did a 5-day challenge and I did some, like, just deep cleaning in my kitchen and rearranging. And I had been maintaining sort of like this lighting candles and and noticing energy and working with like small pieces. But if I don't maintain the feng shui, it all falls apart.
Yeah.
So we're here to say that to you. Right. Like, we're not here to say like there's some easy button and you're going to click it and everything's going to change. Like, we show up literally with you doing the work at your side. Now, we've done so much of it that we are in some ways experts, because we know how to do it for ourselves and we can show you how to do it for you. And we've worked with client after client after client who it's also worked for. So yeah, we're going to show up transparently, sometimes probably vulnerably.
Yeah, I was just thinking about the fact that, that during that that 5-day challenge, the love corner in my kitchen is my refrigerator. And I finally dug in and cleaned out the refrigerator. And my husband and I have been so sweet to each other on such a, it makes my heart. Yeah, it's just been, there's been a different energy around our relationship. Wow. And so that's the magic, right? That's the magic of feng shui, that it shifts things. I didn't tell him that I was cleaning the refrigerator because it was in our love area and it was part of the 5-day challenge. I just did it. And then all of a sudden, and even my son is asking how I am.
Yeah.
And, you know, my daughter is engaged and, you know, my teenage daughter, you know, is engaged. That says a lot, you know. So it's
warmed
just,
up that refrigerator,
right? Warmed up the love area.
I love
so,
it.
Yeah. So that's the type of thing that you will hear us talk about.
Yeah.
Is our own lives and the real experiences that we have doing this work.
Yeah, because I did the 5-day challenge, went all in, and my dishwasher broke.
Right.
And so now I have a ginormous dishwasher bill. I do have a beautiful new working dishwasher.
Gorgeous.
But it actually stirred up a lot of things for me that I wasn't so excited about. Yeah. And I love that. Like, I'm like, oh, there was some energy that needed to shift, and I'm still like clearing away some of the junk there, but I can't get to the awesome stuff unless I move that out. So
that's peeling back the layers. Right?
I literally had some
Leftover.
I don't know. Yeah, I was like, are we swearing on this podcast or not? But I had some dirt to clean up, and I did, and now it's like coming back around. But we're here. We're going to be honest with you about how it works in our lives, and we're going to help support you through how it's going to work in your life. So, what else? What can you expect? You can expect us to provide a weekly episode. So we will be sharing a weekly podcast in iTunes. We're also going to upload that to YouTube. You can watch it and subscribe there if you like. We're going to put it the show notes, like sort of in a blog format on our website. So for those of you who like to read, we are going to make this so easy
so
for you.
So easy.
We are practically doing the work for you. No, but yeah, you can expect us to keep showing up. This is a commitment we know we're stepping into. And we're going to make it as easy for you to follow along in the journey as possible. And we're also going to keep providing opportunity for you. Like, the podcast is a really great way for us to reach as many people as possible. But there'll be some of you who are going to jump on the opportunity of working with us directly. And so we'll keep sharing with you the ways you can step in and dig into the one-on-one stuff, because that's where the like really crazy shifts happen, is when it's like, hey, Jen, here's what's happening in my house. Mm-hmm. Like, I know you talked about this, but this is what it looks like in my house. And then Jen's like, oh, I see what's going on here.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because we can be as broad as possible. Like, the tools are awesome, but there's no one size fits all. So when you jump in with us one-on-one, it is a different experience. So we'll definitely provide opportunity for that. Mm-hmm. And then the format, do you want to talk a little bit about what the format looks like?
So in those show notes, you'll have your weekly journal prompts, right? So you can get into that internal work, right? And, Amanda will provide you with her magic, which is digging into what the thoughts are that are going on around that particular subject that we're talking about in the podcast and how you can work through that. And then also I will be providing you with the feng shui action steps. And so each week you'll be getting this internal work and you'll be getting this external work and you'll be getting the magic of what connected growth is all about.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Woo! Mm-hmm. All right.
High five.
We're pretty excited.
You can't see us. We're always high-fiving.
We are. We're high-fiving and boosting up the energy. And it's good times over here. So we're excited to allow, like, to give you an opportunity to come in and be a part of that with us. So
I just realized they should find a buddy to listen to the podcast with and do the work with, right?
It's true. It
has worked so magically for us, having this accountability and having the co-coaching works fantastic for our clients, but it also works fantastic for us.
Yeah, it does. A great idea. Yeah. It's a great idea. If you can find someone to start listening to this with you weekly and just check in and be like, hey, did you do that? Did you write that journal stuff? That was crazy. This is what came up for me. Mm-hmm. Or you're not going to believe it. I actually started making my bed every day and it made a difference. So it's really fun. Surround yourself with people who want to grow, and like all the places we said, who's this for? Like, find someone else like you who this is for, and really just surround yourself with that energy all the time, because it just magnetizes. Like, everything expands and multiplies when you are doing the work besides somebody else. Yeah. Cool. All right. Well, until next time.
Yeah.
See you next week.